ಪ್ರಿಯಾಜನಾರಾಧಿಕಾ ರಾಮನ ಭುವನ ಸುಂದರ
ಬೋಲೋ ಹರಿ ಹರಿ ಮುಕುಂದ ಮೋಲಾ Jagati putra padam chalebe.
सद्वर्तितो जगति पुत्रपादं चलेवे
दुग्धा वसूनि वसुधा सकलानि येन
याद्वेनामुत्पदा गतं विजावक्य वज्रा निष्कृष्टा पौरुषा पदं विराये पतन्ता राज्वर्जितो जगति पुत्रपादं चलेदे दुग्धा वसूनि वसुधा सकलानि येन
less intelligent mass of people have a very little knowledge of their own welfare, as a child has very little knowledge of its future well-being. The experienced father guides the innocent child towards the path of progress, and the child and the childlike mass of people need similar guidance. This standard welfare codes are already there in the Manusamhita and other Vedic literatures. The learned brahmanas would advise the king in terms of these standard books of knowledge, and with reference to the particular situation of time and place. Such brahmanas were not paid servants of the king, and therefore they had the strength to dictate to the king on the principles of scriptures. This system continued even up to the time of Maharaj Chandragupta, and the Brahmin Chanakya was his unpaid prime minister. Maharaj Vena did not adhere to this principle of ruling, and he disobeyed the learned brahmanas. The broad-minded brahmanas were not self-interested, but looked to the interest of complete welfare for all the subjects. They wanted to chastise King Vena for his misconduct, and so prayed to the Almighty Lord, as well as cursed the king. Long life, obedience, good reputation, righteousness, prospects of being promoted to higher planets, and blessings of great personalities are all vanquished simply by disobedience to a great soul. One should strictly try to follow in the footsteps of great souls. Maharaj Vena became a king undoubtedly due to his past deeds of righteousness, but because he willfully neglected the great souls, he was punished by the loss of all the above-mentioned acquisitions. In the Vamana Purana, the history of Maharaj Vena and his degradation are fully described. When Maharaj Prithu heard about the hellish condition of his father, Vinu, who was suffering from leprosy in the family of Amalekha, he at once brought the former king to Kurukshetra for his purification and relieved him of all suffering. Maharaj Prithu, the incarnation of God, descended by the prayer of the Brahmanas to rectify the disorders on earth. He produced all kinds of crops, but at the same time he performed the duty of a son who delivers his father from hellish conditions. The word putra means one who delivers from hell, called put. That is a worthy son. for hearing Lord Brahma describe the inclinations of the Lord, Lord Brahma's instructing his son Narada Muni. Narada Muni wanted to know about the Lord's different inclinations. So Lord Brahma is describing these different inclinations. Previously, so Lord Brahma is describing the incarnations of the Lord to Narada Muni. And previously he described Dhruva Maharaj. The previous verse was Dhruva Maharaj. So next, in the line of Dhruva Maharaj, in the same line, one of the descendants of Dhruva Maharaj was Maharaj Anga. Maharaj Anga, he had a son called Vena. And this Vena was very demonic. You heard this. Dead body. churned some, they churned the spies, and from the spies, the Nishida came up. The king of the Nishidas. The Nishidas are like Kirita, the other aborigines. Africans,
the
tribal,
yeah, you know, so they live in the jungle, they live maybe like headhunters like that, you know, in Borneo they have these headhunters, keep the skulls, so like that, it came from the thighs, so then. Then he continued churning and then he got Maharaj Prithu, the preacher's Maharaj Prithu. So Maharaj Prithu is actually the incarnation of God. And it was Maharaj Prithu who brought back the righteousness on the planet. During the time of Vena, because Maharaj Vena was so bad, the earth was not yielding any grain. Because if there's no sacrifice, if there's no yajna being performed, then the earth won't provide any crops. Right? It says, Anad Bhavati Bhutani Parjanyat Anasambhavaha. Right? All living entities subsist on food grains, and grains are bought, produced by rain, and rain is born of sacrifice, and sacrifice is born of prescribed duty. So the duty of people to perform yajna, to do sacrifice. And when they do sacrifice, then you get nice, you get rain. And with the rain, then the crops grow, you get enough food. But what happened, Maharaj Vina, he was so demonic, he stopped all the yajnas. So there was no yajnas being performed. So the earth was not yielding any food. There was no food for the people to eat. So it was a problem. So Maharaj Prithu came, when Maharaj Prithu came, he did yajna, and he got Mother Bhumi. Mother Bhumi is a personification of the earth planet. And he forced Mother Bhumi to produce grains, because Maharaj Prithu was doing yajna. Maharaj Prithu is very expert. He's an example of a person who achieved perfection by worshipping, by doing worship of the Lord by performing these yajnas. So by these yajnas, then the earth started to produce food again. So that was one thing Prithu Maharaj did. And we're also told that as a son, the duty of a son is to deliver the father. The son is called Putra. Putra means one who saves the father from going to hell. And there's a hellish planet called Put. So when the son is a good son, then he will save the father from going to hell. If the son will not save the father from going to hell, then the father thinks, what was the need to have a son? The son is not saved, he's not helping me. So there's Putra and Mutra. Mutra means urine. And so urine and the son, they both come from the organ of the man, the genital of the man. So the father thinks, if he can't have putra, better just to have mutra. You no need to have a son who is useless. If the son doesn't save the father, then the father thinks, I might just as well pass urine rather than have a son. But Maharaj Prithu, he was a good son. And he said, although his father was a demon, Maharaj Vena was a demon, Maharaj Prithu, because he was the incarnation of God, Shakya Vesha Avatara, he saved his father from going to hell. Got him delivered. Just like Prahlad Maharaj saved his father from hell. Hiranyakashipu was a big demon, but because Prahlad was in that family, so all the ancestors got to live, including Hiranyakashipu. So you just have, if you just have one devotee in the line of the family, then for many generations they can all be delivered. see, when the people are very pious, then there will be a lot of resources given by the earth. Things like gold comes from there, and then from the sea you get pearls, and different precious gems. All of these things are gifts from God, you see. But we have to recognize the proprietorship of the Lord. We don't want to just take everything for our own sense gratification. So when people are all greedy and they just want for their own sense gratification, then Mother Earth will not give. She will restrict what she gives. She will not give any of the wealth or any of the alms. And she becomes unhappy. Just like you see 5,000 years ago at the time of before the appearance of Lord Krishna, Mother Bhumi was overburdened by all the demonic kings. There were so many kings on the planet, and all these kings were doing atrocities. They were doing bad things on the planet. So Mother Bhumi, she went to Lord Brahma to complain that you have to do something, that my planet is overburdened with all these demonic kings. And Lord Brahma then prayed to Lord Vishnu, and Lord Vishnu said that I'm going to come in the Yadu dynasty, and you should all go and take birth there, and you come and I will correct the situation. And it happened. The Lord appeared in the Yadu dynasty, and he set about arranging things like the battle of Kurukshetra, so all the demonic kshatriyas could all be taken away from this planet, and relieve the earth with the burden. So this was Maharaj Peter similarly, he was doing a similar thing. He was correcting the situation on the earth so that he could restore the righteous condition, make the planet pious again. When the planet is pious, then all the resources will be provided by the earth. The trees will give a lot of fruit and flowers. But if we exploit, we do everything like genetically modifying everything, chemicals, insecticides, and so many things like that, then it affects the whole earth. So the earth will restrict giving. But if we use everything in a nice way, in a God-conscious way, then the earth can give more and more. We give more and more for the pleasure, for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord. So Maharaj Pito understood this, and he was a very righteous king. He did a lot of things. Like one of the things which he did was he leveled the land so that they could do farming. And there's in Mayapur there's a place called Pitu Kuru. Just the same Marari Bhukta's house. Pitu Kuru, there's a big lake. Used to be a big lake. Maharaj Pitu made a big lake.
The Padi Field from the modernism.
Yeah. Mm. It's called Pitu Kuru. Pitu Maharaja was there in Mayapur. Did these kind of things, flattened the land, making it level. So it's easier for agriculture. It's all built in the world, and you can't do so much. Maharaj Pito protected the people also from all the villains. Before Maharaj Pito, there was no king, so the villains, the dakars, the thieves were plundering everyone and terrorizing people. People were all afraid. But then Prithu Maharaj came, and he's a king, and he set about restoring law and order to everyone, all the thieves, and he went to Hadija King, because Maharaj Prithu was there to rule, and he was punishing these thieves if he caught them. So this is something about Maharaj Prithu. You can read also in the fourth canto, Prithu Maharaj is the fourth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. How Prithu Maharaj performed the sacrifices.
is a situation of that. The minute they are like a human being, they will. Only the Brahmin or only pure people only can understand this incarnation of Brahman.
Yeah, the Brahmanas, they can recognize. Other people, they don't care. They don't care, they just think about eating and sleeping. They think and just ending. They don't care who is you or not.
The case of Veena, when they already passed away, then their soul is leaving the body, then the body still have a value. But so they are staged as the Brahmin used the dead body to make the turn.
Yeah, they turned out from the dead body.
Yeah, because Maharaj mentioned, he said, because he's coming from the very, very high family,
yeah,
they bring the servant.
The seaman.
But after the death, what's the value of the thing? Is it gone with the soul?
Sinner?
Yeah, even all the good quality, all the punya.
Well, after the death, but there's still some things there in the body. There's still the good qualities and some things are still there. So the Brahmanas could take them from that body. Because they preserved the body. This the mother had preserved the body. So the Brahmanas came and they trimmed from the thighs and they got the nithida, the nishida, the hukka.
Just we always believe when they are dead, the soul will leave, then they all leave them. The body is no value at all.
Yeah, the soul leaves the body, but somehow you have to read that chapter again. It's in the fourth canto, chapter 15. We were reading it recently, and it's mentioned there how even though the body's dead, that they can do things like that, can get things from the body. But the Brahmanas were so powerful. Because the Brahmins were so powerful, they could curse him to die. So they were very powerful, you know. It's not Kali Yuga. There's another
he can use a dead body to...
Huh?
He can do the... can use the dead body to do something, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, they're making it from the dead body. They're making some valuable things. Yeah, because we said it's connected to Dhruva Maharaj. So the semen of Dhruva Maharaj is there in the body. So we wanted that. So take out the interested in opulent living. They're not interested in material comforts or becoming rich. They're pursuing the truth. They're on the path of truth. But when the king becomes corrupt, then he wants to take advantage. He wants the brahmanas to think of, just like in Europe, there was this one king, he was the king of England. So he wanted to get a divorce and remarry. But in the Catholic Church, he couldn't do that. The Catholic Church, they don't allow divorce. So this king, okay, I'll make my own church. So he made a new church. So that he could get divorced, and then he had more women, have more wives. So that's what, how you got Protestant. The Protestant church came up like that. The Protestant, you have the Church of England, you have this
thing.
It all came, they broke away from the Catholic Church because this one king wanted to get a divorce so he could marry some other women. So he
previous verse they say about the Guru Maharaj, he's internally living in the planet, yeah, internal planet.
Yeah,
Dhruva Loka. Then what did the descendant become into the earth?
Huh?
The Veena is a descendant of him.
Yeah, he's born in that planet. Maharaj Anga, Anga was the father of Veena. But Anga's wife was dead for some. So she brought this in us, but that's why we got the boy Veena, who was the demon. And they were all, even as a child, he would kill the other boys, he would slay them, he would just kill them. It was so demonic. And people would run away. Here comes cruel Veena. They would all run away, nobody wanted to be near him. It was very cruel.
From the very beginning, huh?
Yeah, very cruel. So the brahmanas of the Krishna, powerful brahmanas, despite their curse, they can keep, despite their anger, by their words.
The curse also not affected.
Huh?
The curse also not affected, I'm telling you.
They are cursed, the brahmanas curse. Yeah, because there's no brahmanas, they can't have any curse, right? Although they try. They may try. It's like the brahmana curse for Chaitanya. I curse you, you will never enjoy material life. The Lord Chaitanya is very happy. The brahmanas have to be selfless. And because of the degradation of the brahminical culture, that was why Lord Buddha came up. Lord Buddha came and led the people away from the Brahmanas because the people were so corrupt. The Brahmanas were encouraging the people to do animal sacrifice. So Lord Buddha appeared and he led the people away. Because before Lord Buddha, only the Brahmanas can read the yellow robe. It's like it's cool. It's not something a Brahmana is very careful. You keep living simply. Live simply. And be careful not to accumulate too much. So Brahmana wants to keep his life very basic and simple. But these Brahmanas have become degraded. They wanted money. They wanted to get more money. And then to make money, they would encourage the people, oh yeah, you have to do this sacrifice, do this yajna. And in this way, the Brahmanas would get more money. So Lord Buddha came, and he taught the people, you don't need to do yajna, just follow me. This way, stop all the animal killing. And he led the people away from the Vedas. You don't have to follow the Vedas, just follow me. But he is Krishna. He's Krishna. So this was his trick. What have to follow him. So what Buddha.
Basically all the modern